Hello, my friend. Welcome to Tubio channel. Look at this, 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 and this. They are QR codes and can be scanned. Recently, generating QR codes using AI technologies, particularly using Stable Diffusion, has become popular. I'm also interested in this topic. Through research conducted on the internet, I have discovered a new approach that has been rarely used. The procedure relies heavily on manual operations and ultimate AI. Haha, without incorporating new technologies. Some comments have expressed the desire to learn how to use Stable Diffusion to generate QR codes. I feel a bit embarrassed that I have to rely on the collective knowledge of other pioneers to perform my own operations. Let's get started. I assume that you already possess basic knowledge about QR code technology. If not, please refer to my previous video, which explains almost everything you need to know. The link is provided in the description below. We all utilize the QR code error correlation level to ensure that QR code readers can restore the correct information. The higher the error correlation capability level, the easier it is for QR code readers to recover the data. Therefore, we typically use high-level error correlation, where 30% of the data can be restored. Let's begin by generating a QR code. Up until this point, most users have been using free QR code generators. I have included a link to one such generator in the description below. Input the required information, such as the YouTube channel link here, and finally download the QR code to your computer. Thus far, all of us have performed similar tasks. Regardless of whether we use online tools or third-party generators to create scannable QR codes with 30% error correlation, the subsequent steps will vary depending on the users. We will all use ControlNet extensions, but the approach will differ. We will also implore ControlNet to generate QR codes. If you haven't installed it yet, go to the extension submenu and find SD webUI ControlNet to install it. There are plenty of tutorials available that explain how to install and use it. At the very least, we needed to download the tire model. If you want to simplify the QR code generation process, the brightness and depth models are often utilized as well. Sometimes, the illumination model is also employed. Visit the URL provided in the description below and download the model control tire, along with the related YAML file. Also, download the brightness and depth model. Place these files in the SD WebUI Automatic 1111 extension folder under SD WebUI Control Mode. First, let's discuss the text-to-image process. I have tested most of the processes they have provided and will provide a brief collective presentation. Number 1. Using two ControlNet modes. I watched a video in which the creator used brightness and tire modes as ControlNet modes. They use DPM++2M colors as the sampling method. I have uploaded a video discussing various sampling methods. DPM++2M colors can generate images quickly and has excellent quality. Another tutorial utilizes brightness and illumination as ControlNet modes and also employs DPM++2M colors as the sampling method. They utilize high sampling steps to obtain high quality images. Number 2. Using three ControlNet modes. In this approach, three ControlNet modes are used: tire, brightness, and depth. Adding depth as the third mode increases the likelihood of successful QR code generation. The generated QR codes are impressive. Number 3. Using a specified trained ControlNet mode. One approach involves using a specially trained ControlNet mode called QR Code Monster. It can generate excellent QR codes, but adjustment may be required, and the success rate can be questionable. Another approach is called ControlNet QR Code. It can also generate very good QR code images, but also adjustment is needed. Based on the investigation, Now, I propose a modified method for generating QR codes. It involves using two ControlNet modules as the base. The first module selected is specially trained ControlNet module, of which three modules are available. All capable of generating good QR code images. Another module is selected as the second supporting module. And in this case, the tire motor is used for testing purpose. The parameters I frequently use are listed here. Let's try some of them. Is a brief explanation. If the images more closely resemble QR codes rather than good pictures, try reducing the weight of the ControlNet motor slightly. If you want to increase the scannability, increase the motor weight. Both options have chance of success. The choice of checkpoint motor also significantly impacts the QR code. I have tested almost all motors except SDXL, as they are not yet compatible with automatic 1111 and SD2.1, which sometimes causes issues. The resolution of 512x512 is too small, so I adjusted the select 768x768 or even 1024x1024. However, in such cases, some unpredictable images like double heads or too many people may occur. Therefore, sometimes I start with 512x512 and then use high-resolution fix 1.5 or 2 scaling factors to obtain the final images. These settings work well, albeit requiring a bit more time. Most of the other parameters are kept as default. I use an iPhone QR code reader and check the scalability of the QR codes and rate their ease of scanning using stars. Five stars, very easy. From large to small sizes, almost all checkpoint motors have generated scannable images, most of which receive five stars. Therefore, this method is highly effective for any motor. I have also experimented with various prompts, and even a simple prompt can generate high quality and scannable QR code images that blend seamlessly with the underlying images. Now, let's try another motor for ControlNet 2. This time, I'm using the depth motor, which presents slightly more challenges compared to the tire motor. The inference is much more large. By decreasing the weight to 0.3, the resulting QR code appears very neat and beautiful. The brightness and the illumination also can influence the QR code image quality. I have not yet completed the test of these parts yet. I will make a final version soon. Certain checkpoint motors perform better than others and are capable of generating stunning and scannable QR codes, including rev animation, ICB, I can't believe it, dream shape, deliberate, Game Icon Institute, Ghost Mix, Protergene, and more. Up to this point, we have learned how to generate scannable QR codes with a very high success rate. You have a variety of choice to adjust the parameters, such as using different specially trained QR ControlNet models, or employing alternative ControlNet methods like tail, depth, etc. By following this approach, you can generate scannable QR codes without the need for further modifications. The next part is for advanced users, or those who prefer to dive deep into the process. This session may be less immediately gratifying, and it focuses on how and the why of the processes. Nonetheless, let's continue. The process unfolds as follows. First, with the prompt, automatic 1111 generates an image that is combined with the ControlNet tail function, resulting in the image being divided into several small pieces. These pieces are mixed with the QR code image, contributing to approximate 70% of success possibility. With the second ControlNet process, the final success possibility increases to about 85%. The introduction of three ControlNet systems further enhances the process, providing additional success possibility, bringing the final success rate to around 90%. The brightness and illumination processes are related to light, but differ slightly in their origin. While one is from the surroundings, the other is derived from the image itself. As for the specially trained QR ControlNet, it directly generated a QR code mixed image, offering about 80% success possibility. The combination process I proposed here is an easily understandable and effective method. The first specially trained ControlNet provides about 80% success possibility, and when combined with the second ControlNet, 35% of the 70% already obtained, it reaches more than 95% success possibility. The addition of further ControlNets, such as a third or fourth, can even achieve near 100% success. In fact, when I scanned the images using the iPhone X QR code reader apps, nearly all of them passed successfully. Some might ask, why not directly increase the weight of the first specially trained ControlNet? The reason is that using a large value would make the first generated image more close resemble a QR code, but it might not be aesthetically pleasing. Thus, we need to find the right balance by decreasing this weight to its smallest limit. By the way, the fourth ControlNet can be utilized here, as the maximum number of ControlNets currently support is 10. All the numbers and mechanisms mentioned are based on my understanding of the process, and they are entirely imaginative, designed for easy explanation. In conclusion, I present a modified 4 ControlNet QR code generator. As you can see, all the weights are small, and the success rate is nearly 100%, producing very beautiful QR code images. If you enjoy my content, please consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching.